Hi everyone, it's Lisa from Canine Clips Dog Grooming Tips, and this is Ginger. Ginger is a Bichon Shih-Tzu who's about 13 years old and been coming to me for 6 years. So she's a little bit timid, as you can see. I'm going to be demonstrating how I groom her in just a different area of my grooming, I guess, area. not my usual spot. Because sometimes you don't get the whole setup when you're grooming somewhere. And that's the beauty of not having to worry about restraints, because you can groom a dog anywhere as long as you have some sort of table. I've done it on countertops and their tabletops and dressers, whatever works for the owner, basically. So I'm usually hiding off somewhere when I'm home at Christmas with one of the dogs, getting them all groomed up. So I just wanted to show you this kind of version of how to groom your dog without any restraints, and there will be no editing to the film as well. So I'll be taking her down to a number 5 clipper blade, and that is 6.3 millimeters. So hopefully you enjoy the video. You can let me know what you think. Please give me a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate that. As well, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already done so. So I hope you enjoy it. So her owner has already bathed her. I'm just going to be doing the grooming with the clippers and scissors today. My beautiful background. Move my koi fish. If they aren't hiding in the corner. I do groom lots of dogs, and all of the dogs I groom, I don't use any restraints, but some of them don't listen as well as this beautiful girl. So if you're interested in seeing more of those types of videos, on my channel I've created many different playlists so that you can find those videos a lot easier. There's also, if you're looking for a certain dog breed, I've also separated them out by dog breed as well, or even just the length of the cut. Harder when you don't have a table that moves up and down, so I gotta kind of twist and turn. But I can get her. since she's staying so nice on this side. So I do have more videos too where I'm just showing you the trimming of the face or the feet or nails, and in those videos I'm a little more descriptive of the process and the techniques that I'm using. Full length videos, unless it's a difficult dog, I don't talk as much. So I find people don't want me to. They just prefer to watch. Okay. get that hair that's kind of going in her mouth. There we go. Ears are a little pink, but they are healthy. I know my finger's in the way a bit, but like I said, I do have videos broken down if you're looking for something specific. I'm just, for instance, plucking the ears. I do break it down a little bit, the process. There, so not too bad in there. I'm just gonna see. So when she smiles, it kind of pops out a bit more. So I'll kind of round that a little bit more so it doesn't stick out as far when she gives us that grin. And I go this way just because it layers it a little bit better. Nice and clean in there. The hair is, it doesn't have any wax on it. Go. Again, not very much. That's good, nice and clean. Okay, I'm going to continue on with the clippers. I'm going to use a number 7. In the inner legs, in the back, and in the bum area. Okay. There's a nail bleeding. So it's nice to have a light table. It's not uncommon for the nails to bleed once you cut them. That quick does grow, so if they're not cut regularly, that part that bleeds grows as the nails grow, and it can get quite long. But as you can tell by her reaction when I was trimming her nails, it didn't really bother her. So it's good to have that stick dip powder. And you can trim those nails nice and healthy. I think it's from this front one here. Yeah. Leaving a little trail for me. Let's see. Yep, yeah, two. Two long ones. Just want to make sure you push it in there. So it cluts. Okay, so I'm just about done here. Hold on, little girl. I'm just gonna grab a paper towel to wipe that up so she doesn't step in it. Again, I'm just going to go over her body real quick. Make sure I got everything. And even when you do it the first time, even though this is still the exact same cooker blade, you can still take some more off. Just because the hair does lay in different directions. So if you really want a clean cut, you always got to go back a second time. In some areas. But generally, you'll get a little clump here and there just because you didn't catch it the first time. There, we got lots of hair. That's why I always wear a mask. There's lots of little fine particles flying around too. So when you do groom your dog, you'll notice all these little fine hairs. So, you know, if you can do this grooming in a bathroom or an area that, you know, you can vacuum up after, you know, that'd probably be a better idea. Okay, let's do your tail. If it was matted, I would use my thinning shears. Just the normal hair that gets caught in there. I'm just going to give it a little trim. And I'm rounded out there. Let's see, my fish are very interested in us. What's going on out here? Solution. And then I'm gonna brush your teeth here for the grand finale. So thanks everyone for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. After I'm done videoing here, I'm gonna take her and just give her a little quick blow dry to brush off all these little particles of hair. So it's usually a good idea, unless it's nice and warm outside, you can just throw them right outside, because they'll have a lot of little fine hairs that'll kind of come off after they're done being groomed. So hopefully you enjoyed it. And as I said before, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And let me know what you think about the video in the comments. And of course, if you ever have any suggestions of videos you'd like to see, please let me know that as well. Thanks a lot, guys. We'll see you again soon.